Beloved members of my hometown, most notably those in Choma, and to our wonderful Zambian family, greetings, Zambia. This is Dr. Tony Luck coming once again into your homes. This is my farewell address to you, and I want you to know that as the international spokesperson for my hometown, I have so loved coming to your homes and hopefully your hearts during the past few months to bring you information and inspire your excitement about the Miss My Hometown pageant, which took place this past Saturday, the 2nd of July in Choma, Zambia. I hope you had as much fun watching our talented, beautiful, and courageous young women and mature women as we had creating such an event to honor and celebrate young ladies and mature women from across the great nation of Zambia. Before heading home back to South Africa, I've stayed in Zambia for a few days after the event. I've had such a great time meeting so many of you who were touched by our efforts, and I have been humbled. I've also, unfortunately, observed a number of comments on social media which are heartbreaking and which threaten to mar the noble intended goals of the mission of my hometown and Miss My Hometown pageant. Important among these goals that we have has been our desire and ability to take a strategic role in helping to unlock human potential and self-emancipation. Moreover, these hurtful and unfortunately hateful comments also hurt the wonderful Zambian women aged 18 to 60 who work so hard to be all they could be and to bring forth the best in Zambian womanhood. Such women are a great blessing and a gift for any nation. As my time here on this adventure is coming to a close, but of course I will be back to Zambia as it's my fourth home, a few very important truths I want to share in hopes to dispel the penchant for negativity that is trying to destroy the positivity that the Miss My Hometown has garnered from millions around the world. Indeed, with our amazing media partner, Crystal TV, Choma was seen around the world. Zambia was showcased to millions on six continents. So allow me to share these important truths. Firstly, there can never be a non-governmental organization that does not have government support. Otherwise, NGOs like My Hometown would not have been registered. Thus, we value the government support. Secondly, we say this over and over and over, but it continues to be needing to be repeated. My hometown is not, I repeat, not, I repeat again, not a political organization. It is a nonpartisan organization in development projects and therefore continues with its policy of supporting the government of the day and working with government merely as a support tool. So I'm going to say it again. We are not a political organization and have no desire to do anything more than what we do. We are business people and we are people who are moving to ensure massive economic development for our people because we know that's the only way Africa will survive. Thirdly, my hometown is not funded by any one individual, but by a collective, including and especially the involvement of diasporans like myself and others taking interest in enticing and inspiring big business to network with Zambians to secure business opportunities. Fourthly, we are ever grateful for the administration of our current president. The government assisted greatly in making sure that visas for our guests were processed in good time. The government assisted greatly ensuring that the tax exonerations were granted to the NGO, which is a normal course. Of course, our goal was to ensure that everything that was needed for such a massive project was sourced in Zambia so that Zambians could participate in economic development, and starting with our own hometown of Choma. However, there were some items that could not be sourced in Zambia and had to be imported. We are so grateful to the government for making the process of these items entering the country smooth and seamless. Fifth, To see and hear negative sentiments against government or against the NGO is very painful, and one must recognize it cannot, that kind of energy cannot advance the noble cause. And we must continue to remind ourselves that no international organization, diaspora or otherwise, will involve themselves in a project that operates outside of government sanction. And finally, I sincerely appeal to the My Hometown members to always take the high road that our chairman built this vision upon. And please refrain and avoid making any statements that might impact the organization negatively. We love you, Zambia. We're looking forward to being back with other amazing projects and programs. And we wish you all the very best. And we hope you will pray for our young ladies. They're going to be on the road expressing their gratefulness to being Zambian. They're going to be going to other countries talking about Zambia. And we certainly don't want them to meet negativity, unfounded rumors and negativity that could mar their ability to represent Zambia in a high and honorable way. So this is Dr. Tony Lux saying I love you. We'll see you again soon. May God bless Choma. May God bless Zambia. May God bless Africa. Good night.